Hi, my name's Daryl Peterson, and I'm the manager of the Applications Engineering Department here at Micromeasurements. I'd like to take a few minutes with you this afternoon and show you an example of a full bridge circuit. This one happens to be a full Poisson bridge. It's one of the most common designs where we use a full bridge circuit to measure either compression or tension, either in a typical load cell, or it could be used for a tension link. There's a variety of different applications where you might find this circuit used, but I want to take a few minutes and just kind of show you the basics of the circuit. If you look at the sketch, you'll see that we've got two T rosettes mounted on each side. And just to remember, a T rosette means that you've got two sensitive grids. One is turned perpendicular or 90 degrees to the other. These two T rosettes are bonded onto opposite faces of this machine piece of metal. It kind of looks like a dumbbell in this case. And the reason for that it necks down or it gets smaller in the middle, is to try to get the sensitivity up due to the load or the force that's being applied. So we've got two T rosettes. We wire them together into a full Wheatstone bridge. And you've got the bridge circuit there in the middle. You'll notice we've got P plus and P minus. That's our power that's powering the circuit. And we've got S plus and S minus, and that represents the signal out of the Wheatstone bridge. We've got capital E, which is our excitation. That's the voltage to power the circuit. And then small e sub O, that's the electrical output we get from the circuit. So as we apply a tensile load, as illustrated here, given by P, we start to pull this element, and as we pull the element, the grids labeled as R1 and R3 go into the positive direction, or the tensile strain direction, and grids R4 and R2 would actually see a compressive strain due to the Poisson effect as this member gets longer. So it gets longer along the axis, and it narrows down in its cross-section, and we take advantage of that with those two gauges, R4 and R2, that are turned in those directions. If we assume a Poisson ratio of 0.3, then that means for every 1,000 microstrain of tension we get in R1 and R3, we get minus 300 microstrain of compression in R4 and R2. And we wire that into the Wheatstone bridge so that electrically speaking, all that would cancel. One of the things to remember about a Wheatstone bridge is that opposite arms electrically add. So if you notice, R1 and R3 are in opposite arms, and they're both seeing the same sign, both seeing the same change. And then R2 and R4 are also in opposite arms. So electrically speaking, they're going to be additive as well. So we go around the Wheatstone bridge. If we put enough load on it to produce 1,000 microstrain in the direction of R1 and R3, we'd find that we'd get a total bridge output in this case of 2,600 microstrain, assuming a Poisson ratio of 0.3. So basically, this means the circuit is going to be 2.6 times higher in sensitivity as what you would find over just putting a single gauge on it. Not to mention, one of the best attributes of this is that not only it senses that tension or compression, it can also cancel bending loads. And that's the reason why we position the strain gauges to be on opposite faces of each other. So as you start to bend it, now the Wheatstone bridge would effectively cancel the strains that were due to bending and only measure the strains due to axial. If we look at a summary, one of the nice things about this circuit as well is that you've got all four sensitive grids on the same material, and that should allow for compensation of your thermal output, assuming the material expands the same in all directions. It's going to be sensitive to axial loads, as we mentioned. It's going to cancel side bending and torsional loads as well. If you wanted to calculate the number of active arms, the number of active arms is going to be equal to N, which is equal to 2 times 1 plus the Poisson ratio. So for example, if your Poisson ratio is 0.3, then your N, or number of active arms, effectively is 2.6. And as I mentioned, this means that you're going to get 2.6 times more electrical response given the same strain level in the part if you were to use just a single strain gauge. So it gives you more output, cancels unwanted loading conditions, and is sensitive to just axial loads. If you'd like to find out more about a full Poisson bridge, take a look at our website at www.micro-measurements.com.